Queen, and I am elated to welcome you to the Black Speakers Network Marketing and Sales Success Summit. It's finally here, and I'm even more excited that Brian and his team have asked us at the Success Tribe Network to co-host this awesome event with him. If you're not familiar with the Success Tribe Network, we are absolutely the community that folks come to build connection, collaboration, so that we can go further, faster together as experts and thought leaders. And because you are watching this, what I know is that you are very likely an expert or thought leader who wants to get their message out there. And the best way to do that is to make sure that you have sales and marketing resources that can get your talks, that can get your message beyond where you are right now, beyond your current audience. And we have a tremendous lineup of experts and thought leaders who do this really, really well, and they want to share their resources with you. You're going to hear about things like special and really important strategies for speaking from the stage. How do you collect information from folks? How do you get folks to take a next step with you when you're speaking? How do you ensure that when you are actually positioning yourself as a speaker, that you are positioning yourself in a way where you are really getting compensated well for the work that you do, getting top dollar? I cannot wait for you to be able to see this awesome lineup of speakers. So do me a few favors. The first is get a pen and a paper. Make sure that you're jotting things down. You're taking advantage of the resources and the special offers that are coming from these awesome speakers. Secondly, make sure that you follow us in the Success Tribe, because we have also an exclusive offer for BSN members that you'll be hearing more about during the summit. But most importantly, take action and make sure that you show up every single day, because there are going to be new and exciting resources with every talk. What does Brian always say? Speak up, your audience awaits. And we want to make sure that that audience that awaits you is ready to take the next step with you, that they know that you are the absolute best and undefeated at what you do, so that we can all go further, faster together. So put on your seatbelt, get out your pencil and paper, and continue to enjoy all of these amazing resources from the Marketing and Sales Success Summit. I can't wait to see you soon. Attention, I'm about to tell you how wealthy speakers make more money, have more referrals, and get way faster paydays. Hey, if you're anything like me, you've been in there where you've done the grind. You've put in your application for every single opportunity out there, and you're waiting for the phone to ring. And it sucks, because when it finally does ring and you tell them your rate, the first thing they try to do is discount you. Well, I'm going to tell you how I changed completely the game when I did a few things: raise my rates and stop vying to be the low price leader. Yeah, you heard me right. I raised my rates. I get paid $30,000 a speech. And my clients include American Airlines, Microsoft, Amazon, Starbucks. Yeah, the big boys. So pay close attention, grab your pen and paper. I'm gonna tell you exactly how I did it. My name is Dawnna St. Louis, and I am co-founder of Fire Savvy. Fire Savvy is a business coaching consultancy, and specifically what we do is we work with experts just like you to turn that expertise into high profit paydays by making sure that you have really solid offers, to make sure that you have amazing leads that want to work with you, and then, of course, to make sure that you have the skills to sell to those leads. All right, so let's go right to it. I'm going to start with the first one, which is, how do you make
more money per contract, per engagement. And this is how you do it. Most of the time when a client calls you, they'll tell you they either want you for a keynote and breakout session. Did you know that you actually, that most event planners and most booking agents are really booking for breakout sessions more so than keynotes? Keynotes are usually those are for people who have a personal relationship with the client that's booking. Yeah, I know. Right? So how do you make more money per engagement? This is how you do it. Besides the fact that, yes, you do need to raise your rates and stop being scared that you're not the low price leader, that's not your job. What you want to do is when you put together your contract, you want to make sure that you have three options: the first, the middle, and the high option. The first option is going to be for what they exactly ask for. Don't go crazy on this one. If they ask you to be a breakout speaker, be a breakout speaker. The second option, actually, I'm going to jump ahead and go all the way to the third option. The third option is going to be the kitchen sink. You're going to be like, yeah, I can be the breakout speaker. I can give everyone a book. I can come to your networking dinner the night before. I can do something else the next day. But you're going to have options in there. You're going to have everything, the kitchen sink in there, right? Then your middle option, you're going to take just a couple of things from that top option, and you're going to add to the middle option. Now you have three options. Here's the thing. Do you know that most time companies will go for the middle option? It's just that no one's offering it to them. So all you have to do is create three options: a high, a low, which is what they want, and something in the middle. They're going to pick the middle more often than not. I have literally added 50% to many of my engagements simply by having a great middle option. Okay, number two, how do you get more referrals? How do you get more referrals? Well, to get more referrals, this is one of the things that I do. So let's say my rate is $30,000 per keynote, and the client that I'm working with does not have $30,000. Which, by the way, is the reason that I raised my rates. I didn't want them to actually have my rate. What I wanted to do was stop calling around to everyone to try to get an engagement. So what I did was I raised my rates, and then the client will come back and go, hey, you know what? We don't have 30, but we do have 20. Now, most of the time, what people would do is they would just go, well, I guess I'll take it for 20. No. What I say is we have a $10,000 delta between where you are and where I am. So what I'm going to do is this: for every referral you give me, I will pay you $1,000. At this point, you're going to need to give me 10 referrals. Can you give me 10 referrals? And that's just one thing I could do. I could say, I want 5 referrals, and I want video, and I want the email list. But I put a dollar value to all the things that I want. By putting a dollar value to all the things that I want, I now have negotiation power. So basically what I'm doing is I'm bartering the delta, the difference between what I charge and what they have. You can't barter the delta, by the way, when you're only charging $2,500 a speech. You got to raise your rates in order for this to work. And I know you're sitting there thinking, but they won't pay me now. They won't pay you now because they don't trust you. You don't even trust you. That's why your rates are so low. So raise your rate and then barter the delta. That's all you have to do. That is a fantastic way to get referrals. I cannot tell you how many clients, think about it, for every client, they're giving me 5 referrals. I mean, hot introductions. So for every client I get hot introductions, 5 hot introductions, right? At a minimum, right? So now I'm getting these 5 hot introductions. I'm going to close at least 4 of them. If I close at least 4 of them at $20,000, that one client was now worth $100,000. That's it. That one client's now worth $100,000. And guess what? Each one of those clients, they're probably not paying the full fee. They're giving me 5 referrals. This is how I got out of the grind of smile and dial. And I started getting hot leads literally in my inbox before I even stepped on stage. Okay, here's number 3. So how do you have a faster payday? Listen, when clients are paying big dollars, they want to save big money. This is another reason why you should raise your rates. So if my rate is $20,000, what I tell them is, listen, what I'll do is if you reserve the date in full in the next 7 days, I will give you a 7% discount. So on a $20,000 program, I'm going to give them $1,400. They will do everything they can to make sure that you have $20,000 minus $1,400 in your account. Do you really think I'm balking about having 18,600 in my account rather than 20,000 plus 5 referrals? Absolutely not. I want to have fun money faster, right? So what I do is I tell them, if you reserve the date in full within the next 7 days, then I will give you a 7% discount, right? It is really an incentive. I'm incentivizing the behavior I want. I want them to pay me sooner. So instead of waiting to 30 days before or waiting or praying that I'm going to get a check afterwards, my checks are already in the bank. All right. So there's your 3 tips on this is how you really negotiate these amazing deals, right? Number one, if you want more money, put 3 options. Number two, if you want to get more referrals, raise your rates. And when they say they can't make that dollar amount, have some options that they can actually buy into. They want to buy into the options. That way you are now consistent with your rate. And they are very happy because they're like, hey, we were able to get a $25,000 speaker or a $30,000 speaker for $20,000. We're able to get a $20,000 speaker for $15,000 or a $15,000 speaker for $10,000 because you had space in your rate to do that. If you don't have space to do that, if you're at the $500 rate and you won't raise your rates, guess what? That's what you're going to get. And then finally, make sure that you give them the option to reserve the date in full. Reserving the date in full is a game changer because, quite honestly, a lot of companies, especially larger companies, have to take the discount. And because they have to take the discount, they're likely to have that money in your bank account sooner than later. What I love about reserving the date in full as well is sometimes when they can't make your number, they want to reserve the date in full just to make your number. Listen, if you want to know how we make the magic of selling more, how we show you how to have more really lucrative, great leads, and how to have offers, like those 3 offers, how to have offers that not only sell, but upsell themselves, then all you got to do is go to firesavvy.net. And if you want to know the secret sauce to actually, you know, having that sales conversation, go to salessuperstar.net and download the PDF that tells you exactly how to do this. My name is Dawnna St. Louis, and I hope you found this very helpful.
From click to customer, creating an email strategy that converts. Believe it or not, even in today's digital world, email marketing is still one of the number one drivers of converting a lead into a paying customer. And today I'm going to show you how you can do that with a strategy that works tirelessly for you. So let's get started. Now, what is in store for you is, for sake of time, we're only going to go over 3 out of the 5 mistakes that most business owners make. We're going to talk about my SOS method to creating an effective and efficient blueprint. We're going to talk about tools you can use for email. And we're also going to share a resource that you can utilize in the end to jumpstart your plan. And even though we can't do Q&A today, you're always welcome to email me your questions. So a little bit about me. You might be wondering, who is this Avery person and why can't she really tell me about email strategy? Well, I've been in the digital space for over 14 years. I've worked as a freelance web designer since 2010, worked for former Governor Dill, worked for the Georgia Technology Authority, and I'm a proud HBCU graduate of Clark Atlanta University. So these are just a few of the hats that I've worn, and I've been able to work and be featured on some of these brands and platforms. But to me, that is not the most important thing about my story. It's that I've often felt like a failure, and then sometimes, despite what I accomplished, still do. And so I'll just briefly go over some of my failures. I started an online boutique and it failed. I tried various entrepreneurial ventures and I got bored. I started an online community for Black entrepreneurs and I pivoted. It's still in existence, but I had to pivot. And I was like, okay, let me start a travel agency because I can literally plan a trip in under 30 minutes. And so I was like, okay, let's start that. But I had one booking and it failed. But really those lessons, those failures were lessons in disguise because I had the knowledge, I had the know of all, but I just needed the right strategy to apply that. And the reason why I bring this up is because we often make failures in our business and make mistakes. But as long as we learn from those mistakes, it will catapult us to the next level, which is why I'm going to go over three of the most common email marketing mistakes. Number one is having a lack of a funnel strategy. Instead of creating a well-crafted plan to identify your customer journey, and I'll talk about that in a little bit of how you can create a funnel. But basically, a funnel is the journey it takes from a lead to become a paying customer. Next is having a generic join my list form or not even having an opt-in at all. So you'll see individuals who will say, just join my list for tips and updates. Well, usually your lead will want something more tangible, like here's 10% off if you are a product-based business, or here are my five top tips to accomplishing XYZ. That gives them more of a strategic idea of what to expect from you instead of just generic tips and ideas. And finally, the third out of the fifth mistake that most entrepreneurs make is not having segmentation for your email audience. So say you meet someone with speaking or say you meet someone with networking. I like to tag how I've met the person or the specific thing that they have opted in for so I can know what content resonates with them. And so how do you benefit from email systems? Number one, you can eliminate manual processes and distribute information faster. You can save money on tools and resources, not spending money all over the place and resources and even time. You can enhance consistency and have the same results and sometimes even better. You can increase your productivity while maintaining efficiency. And then if you are a solopreneur, you have an extra team member that works for you 24/7. Why is this email list important? We all see what's happening with TikTok. And if you think about former tools such as MySpace and Tumblr, they're basically obsolete. And so you want to have a place where you can have control of your contacts. Number two, it also gives you easy and direct access to your audience. You can track your data more efficiently, and you can create targeted content through what we talked about earlier, segmentation. And also you can boost sales with marketing real estate. So you have more real estate than you can utilize on typical social media. And so earlier I mentioned about a sales funnel, and here is the breakdown of what a sales funnel is. Again, it's the journey that your potential customer takes from initial awareness to the sale. It starts off with first your client hears about you through maybe social media, speaking, networking, any other avenue, maybe ads. Then you have the opt-in such as text message marketing. You also have the email or regular direct mail. And then the customer purchases your product or service. And this is what a full funnel process can look like, but we are only covering the awareness to interest stage. So this can be, again, a series of IG lives, speaking, networking, and free webinars. And the interest stage is when they take some sort of action through your opt-in. And it can be a purchase, but most likely it's an opt-in that they will first opt for. When it comes to your email strategy, here is just another reiteration of what that looks like. So it starts with the traffic. Again, we talked about that a moment ago. And then you have your opt-in or lead magnet page. And then we hope they say yes. We look for them to say yes. And then it will give them a series of emails from one to usually typically five, but depending on what you're offering, it can be lower. It could be three. And then you always want to have a call to action with each email. Now, if they do say no, there are a few ways to target them, such as Facebook ads through retargeting, but that's a whole different class. And then also being able to sometimes do an abandoned cart email for if you have a certain platform. So that's some ways to even retarget them if they do not opt in the first time. Here is my method which I call the SOS method to saving your sanity. And this is how you can map out your email marketing strategy and really any operations and systems plan in your marketing, because I am a systems geek and that's what I set up for my clients as well. And it begins with strategies. You clearly outline the business goals and objectives you have. You then take it to the operations and identify all the processes you need to have for your particular process. And then you identify the systems and technology and even people you need to put in place to accomplish that goal. With strategies, it comes with identifying those objectives and goals. And you do want to conduct a SWOT analysis and strategic planning roadmap with SMART goals to conduct that strategy part of the SOS method. And then a part of that is determining what opt-in you have. And that opt-in is what you give someone that's valuable in exchange for the information. So that could be an ebook, it could be a course, it could be an email course, it could be audio files, it could be templates, it could be so many things that you want to give your customer in exchange for their information. Now, moving on to the operation side, you want to pinpoint the business task you need to conduct. So that's creating that lead magnet, that's identifying the way you're going to distribute it, that's also setting it up in the system, which is the next step. So you want to pinpoint all of those tasks you need to accomplish for your email systems or whatever process you have in your brand. Then you want to identify and document those processes. So it's one thing to pinpoint it, but you want to make sure you document it, especially if you're bringing on additional team members. And finally, you want to determine the resources and team you need to have effective operations, which brings us to the S of the SOS, the final S of the SOS method. You want to determine what automation you need for the opt-in and your nurture sequence. Again, you want to determine the right technology needed to support the operations. And you want to incorporate data management to manage the security, the privacy, and make sure that you are getting the results that you need. And just a quick overview of three things that you need to carry out your opt-in. You need a website or landing page. You want to create your copy and format. And you want to automate and segment in your marketing tool. So I know that was a ton of information in a short amount of time, but I have an e-guide that will help take you through the step-by-step process of creating an effective and efficient email marketing strategy. So by using the QR code below, you can access that e-guide. And also, if you have questions, feel free to DM me on social media at Black Woman Moguls, or you can email hello@blackwomanmoguls.com and I'll answer your systems questions or your email marketing questions. Thank you so much for taking the From Click to Customer class, and I cannot wait to see what you do with your email marketing strategy.
Are you ready to share your message with the world? Introducing PitchDB, the all-in-one platform revolutionizing the way speakers connect with podcasts, conferences, and media outlets. With access to over 3 million platforms, finding your perfect speaking opportunity has never been easier. Our AI integrations create personalized bios and pitches, setting you apart from the crowd. Join the movement of speakers taking the world stage today. Join now at pitchdb.com.
Hey y'all, it's Deanna Jean, your collab queen. And experts come to me when they are ready to enhance their visibility, their impact, and their revenue. But the experts that I work with, they want to do that by collaborating with other experts, and we do that in our Success Tribe. Sound like your jam? You want to go ahead and join us in our Success Tribe group? Just go to thesuccesstribe.com, and we can't wait to see you there.
Vernee, and I'm a serial entrepreneur, speaker, author, business coach, and brand strategist. And I'm excited to talk to you all today about evergreen lead generation in your online business. It's one of my favorite topics. So let's dive in. So I'm also the CEO of Simply She, Simply Slay Hard Every Day, where we help our clients struggling with inconsistent income reach 10K plus months within 90 days or less. And one of the ways that we do this is through Evergreen lead generation. So today I'm going to be talking to you guys about the importance of lead generation, the definition of a lead. So we'll do some lead generation math together. We'll talk specifically about Evergreen lead generation itself, and then we'll do some examples of Evergreen content. So hopefully you guys are ready for the naked truth, but nobody's going to wake up and be thinking about your business. Nobody's going out of their way to find you. And you know, the hard truth is that people are on social media for the social media experience. They are there to scroll aimlessly, watch cat, dog, dance videos. That's really why they're there, to be social. They're not really thinking about your business. So there are some things that we as entrepreneurs have to do in order to be able to get them to be interested in what we have to offer. So we need a process and a consistent process to generate leads for ourselves. The reality is that your business needs leads daily in order to be able to survive. And for those of you who aren't familiar with lead generation or lead acquisition, as it's sometimes called, it's the process of attracting new customers and moving them through your sales process. So we need to do this on a consistent basis. If you do not have a process for this or don't do this consistently, then eventually the revenue in your business will stop, and that will stop your business. So I do want to clarify what a lead is, actually. So these are people who have opted in to hearing more from you on a platform that you own. So these are going to be new emails, new contacts, new phone numbers in your customer relationship management system or your CRM. So social media followers do not count. I know sometimes we get wrapped up in growing our social media following, but ultimately a lead is someone who has expressed interest in what you have to offer, and they are taking those steps in order to be able to spend money with you. So why do we sometimes feel that generating leads are challenging? One is because the marketplace is noisy. People are getting bombarded with ads and all types of stuff every single day. So people don't know who to listen to. They don't know who to trust. A lot of times as entrepreneurs, we don't know our target market or our niche. We have unclear messaging, or we just don't have a process for generating leads. So what if I told you that lead generation and sales are just a game of numbers? So let's dive into some lead generation math. How many leads do we really need per month? So if we think about the average closing percentage for new entrepreneurs, and these are industry standards, 15%. If you do high ticket sales, it's about 10%. And then we're going to assume that your offer resonates with your target audience and your niche, and that your main offer is about $5,000. Now, of course, the better you get at sales, the better these percentages are going to be. But in scenario one, if you're only generating 10 leads per month, and let's say you book 5 appointments, that's 0.75 clients with our current numbers. So that means you make $0. In scenario two, if you have at least 25 leads and you book 13 appointments, that means you get one client. With our offer being $5,000, that means you make $5,000. So you come up in the green this month. And then in scenario three, if you get 50 leads, you book 25 appointments, you do 3.75 clients or 3 clients. So you make about $15,000. So the moral of the story is that the more qualified leads that you bring into your ecosystem, the better your chances are of increasing your revenue. So how can we go from scenario one to scenario three? We need to learn how to generate leads for our business consistently. So there's a variety of ways you can generate leads. It could be content or social media marketing, speaking, events, PR. But regardless of the method in which you use, you're going to need a lead magnet in order to be able to do this. So a lead magnet is a marketing term for an item, a product, or service that's given away for the purpose of collecting contact details so you can market to that person later. Lead magnets, for me, are conversation starters, right? So what types of things are typically lead magnets? Here's a list, guys. Feel free to screenshot: ebooks, quizzes, guides, checklists, podcasts, episodes, workbooks, et cetera, et cetera. This is not an exhaustive list, but these are just some common things that you see. So I go a step further with my clients when we create high value lead magnets. So that is something that has a significant value to your ideal audience because it speaks directly to a pain point that ideal client has and solves a very small problem for them wanting to continue the conversation. Your lead magnet is only as effective as you knowing your target market and your niche. That's extremely important. So your target market is a group of customers or clients that you identify to sell your product or service to. So an example of this might be women entrepreneurs, but we can take that a step further and we can say startup women entrepreneurs in the first 1 to 3 years of their business, right? For your niche, that's a specialized segment of the market for your product or service. So if we talk about the health and wellness industry, that's a huge industry. You could do so many things there. It's like, are you teaching classes or are you helping people create meal plans? But saying that you are focused on nutrition and gut health makes it more specific and tells your ideal client exactly how you can help them. So how do you drive people to your lead magnet? Evergreen content, right? So producing evergreen content leads to evergreen lead generation and also automated sales, which we're going to talk about in just a second. So what does evergreen really mean? In the digital space, evergreen means sustainable and lasting, just like evergreen trees. It's content that continues to be relevant long after the date that it's published. So why would you do this? Well, traffic to your content will increase over time, which will increase your brand's visibility, which is extremely important. And having content that's already relevant increases your brand authority. And the potential clients who are searching for that particular subject matter will then see you as an authority because you have all the content that's relevant to the problem that they have, and you're the one to be able to solve this. So some examples of evergreen content formats: how-tos, lists, top tips, videos, articles, blogs, podcasts. Now, I will say that creating content in this format does not automatically make it evergreen, but these formats lend itself to be able to create evergreen content pretty well. So some examples of evergreen content by platform: you can do videos on YouTube or YouTube Shorts. You can do Pinterest. The average shelf life of a pin is about 9 months. Blogs, podcasts. You can do newsletters on link or articles on LinkedIn. So there's a lot of different things that you can do here. How evergreen content generates leads. So usually evergreen content has these elements. It solves an immediate problem for your target audience. It's quickly consumable, educational, thought-provoking, starts a conversation, positions you as an industry authority, right? If you're a coach, let's just say you are a relationship coach and your target market is women in their late 20s to 40s looking to date for marriage. So what if you created a guide on questions to ask on the first date? It's quickly consumable. It's educational because the person who's dating could be like, I never knew what to talk about on the first date, right? Will it be relevant for the foreseeable future? I think first dates will always be a thing. Positions you as an authority, as a relationship expert. And then it's a conversation starter because you can ask them how did it work for them on one of their dates. So we also have an example for consultants. And if you're in the IT space, this may be relevant for you. Your niche is tech systems, network security, help desk. And you create an assessment to know if your IT systems are up to date, right? This is something that would be a conversation starter for sure, because if a company doesn't know, then they're going to have tons of questions for you. It positions you as an authority because you can tell them the things to look for. Is it relevant for the foreseeable future? Most definitely, as things need to be more secure, hacker-proof. I think a lot of businesses, especially if they handle sensitive data, will be interested to know if they need to update their system. So what's next? The next thing to do would be to automate your sales, and we can do that in 5 easy steps. So we create your lead magnet, we create and post evergreen content. Now, the 3 steps we didn't really touch on today were collecting leads on a platform or inside your CRM or customer relationship management mailing system, automating your emails on your list, and then making an offer. So we couldn't cover everything in today's presentation, but those are the 5 steps in order to automate your sales. The way that I support my clients, we have done-for-you services and coaching. We assist in offer suite development. So that's your lead magnet, your low-ticket offer, to your high-ticket offer, digital products. We assist with packaging and messaging. We also build sales funnels. We do your email copy, and we set up your automations. So for those of you guys who are listening to my presentation, I do have a free gift for you today. This is my 4 Figures with Less Than 1,000 Followers course. You don't need a huge following to make money online. You just need an offer that resonates with your ideal client. So you need to know your target market and your niche, and you need to solve a problem for them. So you guys want to scan the QR code, you can do that. And this is my gift to you. And with that being said, that's it. Thank you so much. I invite you all to follow me on social media, Facebook at @iSimplyShe, Instagram at @I_simply_she, LinkedIn at Krystal Vernee. Feel free to visit my website, www.isimplyshe.com. And I hope this presentation was helpful. Thank you so much. I'm Krystal Vernee.
My name is Melinda Holmes, and I am your LinkedIn growth expert. And the name of our company is Above the Lead. And we help small businesses show get more exposure and connect and engage better so that they turn their connections into clients on LinkedIn. And I'm so excited to cover this topic. I'm going to be going over 5 key strategies to turn your connections into clients. And this topic is so near and dear to me because when I first got on LinkedIn for my consulting business, helping businesses with their customer service, I struggled. Although I invested in a coaching program, I had a difficult time and it was really tough. I was getting followers, I was getting connections, but I wasn't getting clients. And now I have 2 certifications as well as experience with helping getting connections into clients. And now I help small businesses do the same. So I'm so excited to cover this topic because I know it will be very helpful for you to stand out on LinkedIn. And I'm just going to read to you a few key reasons why you are missing out if you're not on LinkedIn or engaging on LinkedIn the way you could be. So LinkedIn has the most highly compensated audience than any other platform. They have 61 million senior level influencers and 65 million decision makers, which means that you are able to get past the gatekeeper, get past the middleman, and be able to connect directly with the decision makers. LinkedIn is prime for having sales conversion conversations that solve a professional need. They are looking for you online. There are businesses that are looking to get their problems solved, looking for you to help them. But you just have to be out there. You just have to have the strategy so that they're able to find you and connect with you and you are able to engage. There are 1 billion LinkedIn users and probably a little bit more now, but only 5% are sharing content and actively engaging the right way. So you have opportunity to shine. You have opportunity to stand out. You just need a strategy the way I give and help my clients with a strategy and with a system that they're able to utilize month after month, week after week, rinse and repeat, that helps them stand out, get past the woods, and enjoy the garden and enjoy the growth opportunities. So I'm going to get into these 5 steps. Now, the first step is the most important, and that is to optimize your LinkedIn profile. You have to make sure that your profile is set up with the right wording and the right setup to communicate the problem you solve or the pain that you help to alleviate, or the before and after. What is the transformation you take your clients through? And you want to make sure that is simple and to the point so that you come up in the searches. And when someone comes across your profile, they know that you solve their problem. And you also want to make sure that it's visually appealing. Utilize that banner to attract the clients that you're looking to work with by just having 1 sentence, having a nice graphic, and a call to action. Because what we talk about here is action. How you make actionable setup. How do you have an actionable strategy so that your clients take action, your potential clients take action to engage with you and take that action to the yes. And that is what we help our clients with. So you have to make sure that your profile has the right content so that you attract the right audience. Your posts do better and you show up in more searches. And that is how you would turn those connections into clients. Now, the second thing is creating actionable content. It's not enough to have content that someone can Google or find in ChatGPT. You want to provide your audience with content that is actionable, where they are able to get the help that they need and they are able to see you as a thought leader. You also, at the end of every post or somewhere in your post, have some type of call to action. What should they do after you read your post? It's not enough for them to like and comment, but what action are you encouraging them to take? Where are you guiding them next so that they engage with you? And once again, you're able to take those connections and turn them into clients. So you want to make sure that your content, you have very actionable content and that it stands out from your competitors. Now, the third strategy is connection. We are looking to build a connection. It's not enough to have followers. It's not enough to have people like your post. You want to build a community of people that are actively engaging with you and actively seeking you for your expertise. And you do that by always inputting new connections in your community. So don't get intimidated, but what you will be doing is connecting with 100 contacts a week, 400 contacts a month. LinkedIn lets you request at least 400 contacts a month, but you don't want to just send out blind connection requests without sending a message. That will decrease the chance of your connections being accepted, because everyone is sending connections. Although there's only a small percentage of people posting, there are a lot of advertisers, people spamming. So most users are getting tons of messages, tons of connection requests. So you want to make sure that you're connecting with who you want to help, who you want to work with, and you are connecting with people that are active on LinkedIn. We show our clients how they are able to tell if someone is really a truly active user on LinkedIn, because you only want those active users to be part of your community so that you engage with them and they engage with you. So you want to make sure that there's something that you have in common with them, some key common factors, and that's what we help our clients with. So when you do connect with them, you have a meaningful conversation. You have a genuine organic link, something that they're able to connect with and you're able to relate to them. That increases the chance of building them from a connection to a client. So you send those connection requests, and if you have a strategic messaging, which we help our clients with, it increases your connection requests. Our clients receive about a 50 to 80% connection acceptance rate, where the average is 20 to 30. The reason why it's higher is because we have a strategy that we give them, especially customized for each of our customers, each of our clients, so that they increase the acceptance rate. So you want to make sure you have that strategy to increase the community that you have. That is 200 free leads, strategic leads into your network that you can now have conversations with, a limited direct messaging with, and you can reach out to them for different call to actions. Now, the fourth one is building a contact list. You can have 50,000, a million contacts, but if LinkedIn shut down tomorrow, if other social media platforms shut down tomorrow, where would you have their information? So you want to make sure as you're building these connections, you're building your community, you are capturing their information, their email, their phone number, even their mailing address. So you're able to communicate with them offline and build an email list, an email marketing list, and a contact list so you can reach out to them. Regardless of whether you're on LinkedIn or you're on another platform, you have this asset. It's one of your number one assets as a business owner. So we have a strategic system on how we show our clients how you use your LinkedIn profile by having a strategic link, not just book a call because that's passive, not just go to my website because that's passive, but something actionable. Like if you're an accountant, you would have a title, connect with me so I can show you how to save 50% and get more profit in your business, right? That's actionable. So we work with our clients to create strategic titles so that they're able to increase the engagement with their audience, clicking on their links, and they're able to capture their information or engage on an event. It's all about action. So that is very important that you utilize your profile to get that action so that you build an email list. We have an email campaign that we set up for our clients to show them how they can keep in contact with their client, potential clients offline, and get a message from them from month to month. And that is a key way to grow your network and to turn your connections into clients. And last but not least, we talked about the email campaign, but we also have direct messaging campaigns that we help our clients with. And that is something that you want to do for yourself, is create direct messaging It's not enough to just say, book a call with me. Would you like to get on a call? Would you like to come to my event? That is passive. What you want to do is create actionable engagement by having a series of messages that's building on a relationship, building on interest, building on that demand, creating that urgency. So you have to have a strategic direct messaging campaign so that you are in control, you are in authority to increase the chances of turning that ask into a yes. So you have to focus on working on building strategy, and it's not enough to just send that one message. And we find that our clients get better action taken by their clients by creating these campaigns. So what I have for you, I hope this was helpful, but if you have any questions, you can reach out to me. I'm going to share with you my screen, and what I have for you as a gift and a thank you is a 30-minute engagement guide on how you can strategically engage on LinkedIn in 30 minutes. And you can start small. You don't have to be great to start, but you do have to start to be great. And this is something that I share with my clients so that they are able to utilize this service and be able to increase their engagement on LinkedIn and grow. So as a gift, as a thank you, I have specialgifttoyou.com, melindaholmes@abovethelead.com if you want to email me. But to get that download and get started today, it's specialgifttoyou.com. And my number is there. Feel free to take a second to screenshot. I'll give you a few seconds so you can take a screenshot of the information. But what I will say is take action. Take action, start small, and you will see a return on your investment and you will see better engagement. So I do thank you for your time. It was great sharing with you. Feel free to reach out to me and I will love to connect. And don't forget, get started. It's all about getting into action to turn those connections into clients.
Meet PitchDB, the ultimate platform for speakers looking to make their mark on podcasts, conferences, and media outlets. PitchDB provides access to over 3 million platforms, ensuring you find the perfect avenue for your message. With AI integrations, your bios and pitches are tailored uniquely to each opportunity, giving you the edge you need. Join now at pitchdb.com.
Gentlemen, my name is the Reverend Dr. A. Louise Bonaparte, and I'm honored to speak to you today to discuss a topic that is close to my heart and vital for our professional growth. My presentation is titled Strategic Sales Success. This presentation is tailored for sales professionals like you, who are seeking to enhance your sales effectiveness and achieve greater success in your careers. Now, you might ask, how can I be such an expert on this topic? Allow me to share a bit of my background. My maternal grandmother, the late great Reverend Amanda H. Williams Crawley, was born in Oglethorpe, Georgia. She migrated to Brooklyn, New York in the 1920s, where she started her first business, a humble grocery store, in 1930. By 1940, grandmother owned over a dozen businesses and was my family's first multi-millionaire. Today, not only am I a retired surgeon and bishop with clergy and churches under my leadership in 200 countries, I am the CEO of my family's 94-year-old global billion-dollar enterprise, which has grown into an international conglomerate with over 300 businesses and employees worldwide. My hands-on experience in leading and growing successful businesses across various industries has equipped me with a deep understanding of sales strategies, negotiation techniques, and deal closing insights. This extensive background makes me a qualified expert to share practical knowledge and insights on achieving sales mastery with integrity. Our theme today is Elevate and Empower, transforming ideas into revenue. Through strategic sales techniques and negotiation insights, you will learn how to elevate your sales performance, empower yourselves with valuable skills, and transform ideas into tangible revenue generating opportunities. In under 10 minutes, I will equip you with the tools and knowledge needed to drive success and achieve a revenue growth, perfectly complementing our event theme. Let's begin by focusing on key strategies for maximizing sales outcomes. In today's competitive market, it is essential to set clear, achievable goals. These goals should be specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and time-bound. Planning is equally crucial. A well-thought-out plan not only gives your sales efforts, but also helps you anticipate challenges and prepare solutions in advance. Next, let's delve into negotiation techniques for closing deals. Successful negotiation is not about winning at all costs. It's about finding a mutual beneficial solution. This requires active listening, understanding the needs and desires of your clients, and you're presenting your products or service as the best solution to their problems. Remember, integrity is paramount. Building trust and maintaining ethical standards are essential for long-term success. As you implement the strategy and strategic sales techniques and negotiation insight, it is important to take immediate action. Apply these learnings in your daily sales activities to elevate your performance, close deals with integrity, and drive revenue growth. The journey to success is not a sprint, but a marathon. Consistent application of these strategies will transform your approach to sales, empowering you to achieve remarkable results. To add another layer of depth to our discussion, let's talk about the importance of resilience and adaptability in sales. The market is ever-changing, and with it, the needs and behaviors of our clients. Embracing a mindset of resilience allows you to recover from setbacks and stay motivated even when challenges arise. Adaptability, on the other hand, enables you to pivot your strategies and approach in response to new information and market conditions. By being both resilient and adaptable, you position yourself to navigate the complexities of the sales landscape effectively. Moreover, leveraging technology can be a game changer in your sales strategy. Utilize CRM systems to manage customer relationships, data analysis to glean insight from your sales performance, and social media platforms to engage with a broader audience. Technology, when used effectively, can streamline your process, enhances and your reaches, and provide you with valuable data to inform your decisions. In conclusion, I urge you to embrace a mindset of continuous improvement, implement the strategies and insight we've discussed today to elevate your sales performance and drive revenue growth. by taking action and integrating these techniques into your sales approach, you can transform ideas into tangible results, empowering yourselves to achieve success and make a positive impact in your sales endeavors. Together, let's elevate and empower our sales journey towards greater success. Set goals, plan, apply insights, elevate, close deals, and succeed. You can connect with me on all social media platforms. In addition, please visit my personal website at revdralb.com. Thank you for your time, and I wish you all the best in your journey to strategic sales success. God bless you.
Seal of new skills, new you. And over the next few minutes, come up with something I can share with you that'll change your life today and help you change the world tomorrow. And it's a very simple concept, but I live my life by this concept. And that's one new skill will change your life. So write that down. If you're a person that's thinking about moving to a new city, state, or even country, if you're a person that's thinking about starting a new business, maybe you're thinking about going back to school, before you make any changes on the outside of who you are, I want to challenge you to think about who you are on the inside. And that's where this skills transformation happens. So I thought about, okay, the Black Speakers Network invited me to speak. Shout out to Speaker Cash. That's helped me take what I know, what I've lived, what I've been really good at and not so good at, so that you can have a transformation. And that concept is simple. One new skill will change your life. So I want to teach you something I learned as the 41st hire for a SaaS company, right? And I was tasked with generating revenue. I was tasked with finding opportunities. How many of you could use some new opportunities? How many of you could use another chance to grow your business? How many of you could use one more opportunity to change your life, right? So what we did over those 18 months helped create 5.4 million. Look, I make sure the numbers are right. $5.4 million in pipeline. That means possibilities. That means opportunities. But possibilities don't pay bills, right? 1.3 million in deals closed. Now, I didn't do that on my own. It's part of a team. What I want to teach you is four simple questions that you need to have answers to, so that you can learn this skill, what we call sales enablement. That means creating opportunities in your business. Remember, one new skill will change your life, okay? So you don't have to go back to school for this skill. You don't need to be an extrovert, okay? You don't need to purchase expensive software. You don't need complicated sales methodologies. In fact, I don't want you to be a salesperson at all, okay? I don't want you to be the killer closer or the master manipulator. I want you to be the best version of yourself, the authentic version of yourself, just the one that hears yes more often. So listen, here's the four questions you want to ask yourself, and not just ask yourself to talk out loud, to sing in the shower, but to create answers to, so you can learn this one new skill. And it's a very simple sales enablement framework, okay? Number one is the problem. Number two is the people. Number three is the process. And number four is the price. Okay. Let me break this down in case maybe you have a short attention span. Maybe you're like, where is Bruce going with this? If you're taking notes, it's the problem, people, process, price. So first of all, a lot of you are just amazing. A lot of you are spectacular. A lot of you are unique and wonderful. And you have a solution. What I need you to understand is solutions are not valuable until there's a problem to match. Mm-hmm. A solution becomes more valuable when it's attached to a problem. Okay. Number two, people. And a lot of you have heard this, right? What's your customer avatar? Who's your ideal client, right? What's your ideal client profile? But I'm talking about people. If you are somebody taking notes, right? Note takers or money makers. I want you to write this down. My mentor, when I lived in Nashville, Tennessee, taught me this. I want to share it with you. He told me, Bruce, the only business is people. The only business is people. So I know in this world, if you're watching this in 2024, 25, into the future, there's artificial intelligence, there's automations, right? We're doing things virtually. Do not forget, on the other side of this screen, there's a person or there's people, right? An organization isn't just an EIN. It's not just a corporate address building. There's people, okay? So when we talk about who we serve, that's important because the clearer we are on who we serve, the easier it is to find them and the better we can serve them. And let me point this out as well. Who are you? So we talk about people. Who are you? If I'm telling someone about you, man, I know someone you need to meet. What would I use to describe you? What words would I say to tell someone about you? A lot of times we tell people what we do, but I want to know who you are. So yes, I am a sales trainer. Yes, I'm a personal and professional development coach. Yes, I'm a sales enablement specialist. But who are you? That's what you do. Who are you? And the clearer you are on who you are, the clearer the decision is for your ideal customer to say, yes, this is the person I want to work with. Okay, so we have a problem to go with your solution. We have people, a clarity closes deal. We're clear on who we serve and who we are. We're clear on who we do not serve and who we are not. We're not playing the comparison game. We're not playing copycat. We're being authentic. So let's talk about a process. People know what to do a lot of times. They have a problem, they know what to do. They say, you know, Bruce, I want to lose weight. They know what to do. So Bruce, I want to make more money. They know what to do. Bruce, I want to be able to have peace in my heart and mind. Okay, they know what to do. People will pay for the how to do it. Write that down. People will pay for the how. So that means whether you teach them how or you do it for them, that transformation is what they're paying you for. Some of you ask, well, Bruce, who would pay me for what I do? Someone who's here and wants to be there, and you're the gap. You're the bridge to fill the distance between those two points. That's the process. Processes can be trademarked. Processes can be duplicated. Consistent processes yield consistent results. And consistency is what people pay for. They want to know it works. And they want to know it works every single time. So check this out. We've got problems solved. We've got people, that's clarity. We have a process that's consistent. It's repeatable. Man, let's talk about pricing. Let's talk about pricing. I recommend having two prices. Uh-oh. Stay with me. I recommend having two prices. Simple prices makes a simple decision. A simple price makes it a simple decision. I don't have to figure it out. The answer is yes or yes. Okay, and that's why I want you to have two prices, a low and a higher. I want them to be very simple to explain. I want them to be very simple to understand. I want them to be very simple to share. Now, don't just go around sending people your price list. That's not what I'm asking you to do. I'm only encouraging you to make it so easy for the people that want to work with you to say yes, that they say yes. Okay, awesome. Now, there are people that might need some customized solutions. Here's what that sounds like. Hey, Mr. and Mrs. Client, I'm so excited to work with you. You are the person, the people that we serve the best. You have a problem that we have a process to solve. I'm really excited. The pricing is, option A is 1, 10, 2. And then option B is 1, 2, 3, and 4. What works best for you? They might say, hey, that sounds really good. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. That's when you customize your pricing. Other than that, it should be A or B. That is going to help you hear yes more often. So we did it. Deep breath. That's how we did 5.4 million in pipeline and 1.3 million in deals closed. I'm being clear on the people, being clear on the problem, having a clear process, and very simple pricing. So I pray abundance into your life. I hope for all good things and abundance in your business. And it starts with being able to answer those questions, those four P's, in a clear, concise, and compelling manner. That's going to be the difference between today and that better future that you see in your mind, that you see when you close your eyes. Remember, I'm asking you to change who you are. I'm asking you to grow who you are. And one new skill will change your life.
Hey, y'all. Hey, it's Deanna Jean again, your collab queen. What an awesome day. Wow. So many awesome resources, so many gems that were dropped. Did you catch them all? The good part about this is that because this is being streamed, you can roll back. You can make sure that you have that pen and pad just in case you didn't pick it up at the very beginning, and make sure that you were taking action on the strategies, the resources, and all of the abundance of information that was shared with you today. And also make sure that you join us for the next session. I'm so glad that you are here today. Make sure that you are following Black Speakers Network. Make sure that you are following every single speaker that was here today. And also make sure that you are following me and the Success Tribe Network. And if you have not yet cashed in on your exclusive offer to join the Success Tribe Network, go ahead and go to thesuccesstribe.com. Remember, this is an exclusive BSN offer that is tailored around making sure that you as a speaker are able to get the resources that help you to collaborate, to get in front of more of those warm opportunities. It's an exclusive offer just from us, all for the strength of the fact that you're part of the Black Speakers Network. And I'm so excited that you were here today, and I can't wait to see you again very soon. Have a good one. See you tomorrow.